Addressing the press at Parliament after the caucus meeting at Kololo, the government chief whip David Obua noted that the NRM party chairperson who summoned the caucus had only one item on agenda, which is none other than the rationalization of public entities. President Museveni presented a paper on the matter to legislators and asked them to go and scrutinize it in 2 weeks. Obua says the president wants the reorganization of government ministries, commissions, authorities and agencies to only retain agencies that are doing research and those that generate good income to the government. The position of directors in ministries is among those likely to be phased out in the ongoing reforms, with a view that there is duplication of roles between directors and commissioners.
The rationale or the justification of this study was to reduce on public expenditure, to minimize cost, to eliminate functional duplication, especially in ministries, departments, and agencies of government, including parastatals, and also to take services nearer to the people. He further informed Parliament, the parliamentary caucus, rather, that there is need for government to retain research institutions, ministries and departments and agencies of government, including parastatals, that are making money. This paper was presented later on by the Minister of Public Service. Members received it, and we have deferred debate for a period of 2 weeks, when another caucus will be convened, in order for us to have a full blast debate where NRM Parliamentary Caucus will take a decision based on consensus on this particular subject matter of rationalization of government agents.
Although today's caucus meeting did not take any decision on the merger of government agencies, it is not going to be an event, but a long process that will take a series of phases, as Obua confirms.
I stated earlier on that it will be done in phases. It can't be a one-off. We will do it within some years. It will run over. So this particular exercise of rationalization will be done in a phased manner.
According to the 2017 report that was done by the internal security organizations, which informed the government decision to merge MDAs, agencies generally spend a lot of money on salaries of the employees, taking about 37% of the entire national wage bill when compared to the mainstream public services. Even though some agencies were created by the Constitution, government is committed to take a legal path in doing away with them.
Are created by the National Constitution, others are created by other acts of Parliament, others are created by statutory instruments. We are alive to that fact. And the Office of the Attorney General, who is the principal legal advisor of government, will be in a position to advise government on how best the repeal process will be conducted in a phased manner, just like the rationalization process will also be in phases.
Members of Parliament believe rationalization of ministries, departments, agencies and parastatals was long overdue given the current economic hardships.
We need to merge these agencies because of duplication, wastage of resources. The economy now, the major issue is income. If you look at what we budgeted for, what URA is likely to correct from the taxpayers, there is a very big deficit. And yet, as a country who have been borrowing, we may not even borrow more money from these international agencies because we have gone to a certain limit, which is unacceptable in international standards.
The party chairman will meet the NRM parliamentary caucus again in a fortnight after MPs study his proposal and take a decision on how the merger will take shape. Government anticipates saving 988 billion shillings in merging and disbanding some of its entities. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.